Good morning, friends. I am Professor Shivayogi Patil, working as assistant professor in Thondathara Engineering College, Qatar. Again, I am before you with a small video. This is in continuation with a series of video I have already released with the topic Live Life King Size. So in that 4 or 5 videos, what I have discussed is about the 5 P's which are very important for students to get success, as well as anybody who want to be successful in life. So they have to follow 5 P's. Those 5 P's are the purpose, the performance, the persistence, the priority, and these are the 5 P's what you need to success. So purpose I have already discussed in the previous videos, how purpose is very important. So in NLP language we call it as why. Know your why. That is, before doing any work you should know why you are doing that work. So in our education system we call it as the outcome. We need to know outcome of every thing what we do. So we need to have at least expected outcome, what we call it as. So our education is also outcome based education, where we fix some outcomes and we try to achieve those outcomes. So you need to have some outcomes for your every effort, then only there will be an energy in you, there will be an enthusiasm in you. So today I wanted to discuss something philosophical. You may feel it something philosophical, but it is very, very important for you to understand that what is life. When we ask ourselves this question, the answer will be our life is an energy, and this energy is part of the cosmic energy which is surrounding us. So throughout this entire universe or the planet, so there is a cosmic energy and we are part of that cosmic energy. So our life, what we call it as a soul, what we call it as a soul, soul is nothing but an energy. Then what are thoughts? Thoughts are also energy. Our soul create energy. So soul means it is a combination of what we call it as a mind and the energy which runs our body. Our body is only the supporting system, or it can call it as it is only the what you call it as a protective covering for our soul. So you might have seen in a automobile there will be an engine which is the heart of the automobile, and there will be a covering for it, and covering and other things for its functionality, for its depending upon the functionality. So depending upon our functionality, our body is there. We have 2 hands, 2 legs, so and other things based on the functionality for which we have created. We have been created. Who have created us? So you can call it as a God if you are God believer, or if you are an atheist, you can call it as nature. Nature has created. So therefore, what I wanted to stress out is, so we are just an energy, and our body is just our support system, and memory as well as the mind, what we call it as, it is part of our energy. Memory is also energy, and of course, to support memory there will be something called neurons, cells, etc. in the brain, so that will support the memory. So our mind, what we call, from which we generate the thoughts are also energy. So thoughts, that mind, what we call it as, it is also energy. So if we maintain our body well, so the soul will remain here, our life will be there. So when our body gives up, or when our any of the part of the body like heart, lungs, kidney, there are n number of parts gives up because of many things, you already know why they give up. So definitely our mind stop functioning, our heart stop functioning, So because there is a need for circulation of blood for every part of the body to strive, then our life energy will be released. Our life energy will be released. So where this life energy goes after that, that is again another philosophical question. Most people say that they will search for another body, so they will have some frequency and they will search for another body where there is a chance of birth being taken, like a pregnant woman, where the what we call there is a chance of the life to develop. So there is also a frequency. If the frequency matches, so then that life goes into that womb of that lady, and that embryo, what we call it as, so that it become live and take birth. So this is one of the what you call it as explanation of what after life. So okay, I just for your information, so I'm telling you all this thing. So my main intention is to impress upon you that we are part of universal energy, and universal energy is willing to help us at any moment, at any situation. Only thing, we have to seek that help from the universal energy. We have to seek that help from that universal energy. We have to grab that energy. We have to take that energy and take it into our body through various channels. For example, you might have heard about Reiki, something called Reiki. Reiki is nothing but when you get the Diksha of Reiki, your hands will be converted into a channel to absorb the energy or take the energy of the cosmic energy of the universe and feed it into our body, so that we get energized and some of our ailments will get cured or something like that. So Reiki believes that there is a cosmic energy everywhere, and our life is also a part of cosmic energy. So this is what I wanted to tell. Then our thoughts are also energy. So thoughts are very, very powerful. That thoughts as an energy will release many chemicals inside our body. We don't call them as the chemicals, we call as hormones. So it is a very interesting topic, my dear friends. See, why I am telling you all these things is how your thoughts affects your energy. That is what I wanted to impress upon, and how your thoughts will put you into depression and all those things. So because doctors and scientists have already agreed upon that most of the diseases we get are psychosomatic in nature. Psychosomatic means, psycho means it is all about related to mind, somatic means body. So whatever, most of the diseases, first they will born in our mind, then they will be infiltrated into our body, and then they will occupy our body and do whatever damage they can do if we doesn't prevent them, or if we doesn't take suitable precautions, so etc, etc. So what I wanted to impress upon here is your thoughts are very, very powerful, and experts says we generate about 60,000 thoughts per day in 24 hours. We generate about 60,000 thoughts, and out of these thoughts, 90% of thoughts are negative thoughts. So my dear friends, every negative thoughts affect your body as well as mind, because every negative thoughts release some type of hormones, because our body can be compared to a chemical factory where chemicals are called as hormones. So they release the hormones. There are two types of hormones. One is feel good hormones, then the feel bad hormones, you can say, or damaging hormones. So every negative thought releases feel bad hormones or damaging hormones. So you will get depressed, you will feel drained out, you will feel totally drained out, you lose your energy, you lose your enthusiasm. So because all that is because of the your thoughts. Actually, in very rare cases we exhaust our body. Now ದೈಹಿಕವಾಗಿ ದಣಿವಾಗೋದು ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ತುಂಬ ಕಡಿಮೆ, ಮಾನಸಿಕವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ದಣಿಯೋದೇ ತುಂಬ ತುಂಬ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಪಷ್ಟವಾಗಿ ಮಾನಸಿಕ ದಣಿವೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಅನೇಕ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡದಂತೆ ತಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ ಹೊರತು ದೈಹಿಕ ದಣಿವು ಅಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ದೈಹಿಕ ದಣಿವು ಅವರನ್ನು ತಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್. ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಈಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಕೂಲಿ ಆರ್ ಪುಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಟೋ ರಿಕ್ಷಾ, ಪುಲಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕಾರ್ಟ್, ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ದೇ ಮೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಬಟ್ ವೈ ವೀ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವೀ ಡೂ ಅವರ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸುಟೇಬಲ್ ಕಂಫರ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್, ವೈ ವೀ ಶುಡ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಸ್ಟೆಡ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಹೌ ಅವರ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಸ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಯುವರ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ವೆರಿ ಟಯರ್ಡ್, ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಟಯರ್ಡ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್. ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್. ದೆನ್ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಯು, ಆರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸನ್, ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಯು ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಆರ್ ಟು ಎ ಫಿಲ್ಮ್, ವಿಚ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ಫೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್. ದೆನ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಆಲ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟೈರ್ನೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ವ್ಯಾನಿಶ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಬೌಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ದೇಹ ತಾನಕ್ಕೆ ತಾನೇ ಉತ್ಸಾಹ ಬರುತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ತಾನಕ್ಕೆ ತಾನೇ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ತುಂಬಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಹೌ ಇದು ಹೇಗೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಯಿತು? ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಸೊ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಟೈರ್ನೆಸ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯು, ಯು ಫೀಲ್ ಲೆಥಾಜಿಕ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ದ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಪೇನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಆರ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಲಿಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹಿಯರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ವಿಚ್ ಯು ಲೈಕ್, ಆರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಎ ಮೂವಿ, ಆರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಎ ಪಿಕ್ನಿಕ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಲವ್ ಟು ಡೂ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಸಡನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಎನರ್ಜೈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ವ್ಯಾನಿಶ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಯುಪೈ ದಿಟ್. ಯು ರಿಕಾಲ್ ಸಮ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಯು ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ ಇನ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಡೇಸ್, ದಟ್ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲಿ ಫೀಲ್ ಗುಡ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ರಿಲೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜೈಸ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ರಿಕಾಲ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ some accident or something like that. So if you recall, so others accident or your own accident, might have old accident, so there will be negative thoughts. So those negative thoughts start as the secretion of negative hormones or feel bad hormones, so you may get depressed, something like that. So all this depression and all insomnia, so a lot of diseases what we get is all due to the game played by our mind. So if we can control our mind, if we can control our thoughts, if we learn to produce or learn to subside negative thoughts and learn to produce only the positive thoughts, then we can definitely be energetic throughout the day. Energetic throughout the day. We can be feel good at any given time. So why I am telling this? Because it is related to, first thing is passion. Because see, if you have a passion for anything, then naturally your thoughts will be positive, then it will produce feel good hormones, positive hormones, then naturally you will get energy to do something like that. Second thing what I wanted to impress upon here is, even the cosmic energy, what we call the outside conflict cosmic energy, will help us to energize further if you have a passion. Because you might remember the words of Swami Vivekananda, if you have a goal in front of your eyes and if you breathe it and if you feel it in your entire body, all the muscles, all the cells, in your blood circulation also, if you think only about that goal, then the entire universe will conspire to help you in achieving your goal. entire universe will conspire to help you achieving goal. Andre aa goal anne neevu manasalli tumbikondidre adara baggene neevu vichara maartta idre adu nimge ondu shaktiyanna kodutte adara bagge neevu passion develop maadkondre ee jagattinalliruvanta cosmic shakti ante enantivi adu nimge ondu adu nimge ನಿಮ್ಮ ನರ ನರಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ತುಂಬಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ, ಎಂಥೂಸಿಯಾಸಮ್ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪರ್ಶು. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ಯಾಷನ್. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ಯಾಷನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರಿಯಾರಿಟಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರಿಯಾರಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏಜ್, ವಾಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಿ ಯುವರ್ ಪರ್ಪೋಸ್ ಆಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏಜ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ how you have to perform at this age and all those things, because you are all youngsters. So if you develop that passion, that love towards your subject, your academics and your goals, that enthusiasm to reach the goals, definitely the entire universe, the cosmic energy will conspire to help you in achieving your goals. You will be full of energy. While playing a game, you are full of energy because of that. While playing normally, we will be having positive thoughts. It will generate feel good hormones. Even during exercises, there will be release of many feel good hormones. Testosterone is one of the hormone. I have forgotten some of the names, so I'll tell you in the next video. So those hormones, if they are released, they will fill energy. See, energy cannot be acquired by any pills. There is no medicine, there is no tonic, there is no pills to get the energy inside our body. Our thoughts are our energy. Our mind only can supply us energy in what we call it as a unlasting energy. You can call it as unlasting, everlasting energy it can create. So therefore, my dear friends, start loving your career, keep a goal, have a purpose. I wanted to impress upon one more thing here. See, every creature in this world created by the God or nature has a purpose in it. Purpose. Even small amoeba, even an ant, even a small bacteria. So every creature created by this nature or God has a purpose. They have created a purpose. They have created to maintain the ecological balance of this planet, of this universe. My dear friends, I will tell you a bitter truth. We divide the entire planet into three kingdoms. One is plant kingdom, another is animal kingdom, another is human kingdom. Plant kingdom, of course, involve all types of plants what we have here. And animal kingdom has all type of animals, even minute creatures, amoebas, bacteria, whatever thing. So all those things support the nature, support the ecology of the nature. And the bitter truth is, if entire human kingdom gets vanished from the planet, gets extincted from the planet, nothing will happen to this planet called Earth. It will strive, it will become more beautiful. But one of these kingdoms, that is plant kingdom or animal kingdom, gets extinct, then planet will be like totally in distress, totally in what you call it as a doldrums. So it becomes a hell non-livable by the human beings. So therefore, you can imagine how the plant kingdom and how the animal kingdom are balancing the ecology, how they are serving their purpose. That is what I wanted to stress upon here. So every plant, every creature in this world is serving the purpose. Do you know even the bacterias, what are there? See, our body is nothing but it is a colony of bacterias. So if you listen the lectures of Dr. B.M. Hegde or Sadhguru or anything, they will tell you. It is a colony of bacterias. Every cell has billions of bacterias. But they are good bacterias which support our internal system. So without bacteria, our digestion will not happen. Digestion, digest, they support digestion, they support many functions of our body. We are alive because of the bacteria. If we kill all those bacteria in our body, we will be dead. That is what I wanted to impress upon. So therefore, my dear friends, even bacteria are serving their purpose, their life's purpose. Of course, they are. So they are helping us. Then what we are doing? We are neither supporting the ecology of the nature, we are neither supporting the planet kingdom or animal kingdom. What purpose we are doing? Why God has created? Why should he bother to create us? ಅವನು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಯಾಕೆ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ದ? ಆ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ತೊಂದರೆಯನ್ನು ಯಾಕೆ ತಗೊಂಡ? ಇದು ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ, ವಾಯ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್? Even though human beings are useless as far as ecology is concerned, environment is concerned, or this planet is concerned, we are all waste bodies. But he has created us for purpose. That we call it as the higher purpose. Higher purpose of the character. Okay? That higher purpose is achieve something in life and support this ecosystem. Without supporting this ecosystem, however achievement you do in your life, it is waste. So supporting this ecosystem is very important. Why I am telling all these things is to impress upon you that every one of you have been created by God or nature for some higher purpose. Try to find that purpose. You will get all the energy, enthusiasm automatically if you find that purpose. So how to find that purpose? That is the $1 billion question. So what experts says, or what gurus like Sadhguru or others says, is the answer will be inside you. Meditate. If you go into that meditative state, you practice the meditation, one day you will surely get to know your life's purpose. That is called enlightenment. How Buddha got enlightenment, how Buddha got all the answers of this universe so that he can answer to anybody's question. How it was possible? Because of that enlightenment. That enlightenment may happen to everyone. Therefore, meditation is also very, very important. Sit in a quiet place, meditate, ask yourself question, what is my life's purpose? Maybe it may give you answer, what is the dream of your parents, that may become your life's purpose, or he may give some other answer also. So therefore, find your life's purpose. You have been created for a higher life's purpose, my dear friends. So therefore, please always think positively so that all the energy of the universe will help you to achieve your goal, develop passion in your study, develop passion in your subject. So by that way, you will be definitely go into the path of the, or walk into the path of the success. So with this, I will conclude this video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. And also press that bell so that you will get the notifications for my further videos. Thank you, friends. Thank you. I'm signing.